going to be a little different from the one that was originally planned, and that will be explained as the service goes on. But we begin today with a hymn that asks for Jesus to be our light in the darkness. So let's sing together, Christ be our light.
True.
resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you.
And also with you.
Would you like to sit down? Well, it's been an extraordinary week. A week in which we have seen two prime ministers and two monarchs. A day that we knew would come, and yet somehow we imagined that the Queen was immortal. She has always been there, for most of us, the only monarch we have known. Some of you will have very faint memories of our last king, her father, but for most of us, the only monarch we have really known is Her Majesty the Queen. She is currently en route from Balmoral and going to Edinburgh, where she will lie in state at St. Giles Cathedral, and there will be a service there today with His Majesty the King, the Queen Consort, the Prince and Princess of Wales, William and Kate, and other members of the royal family. She will then fly Tuesday, I think, to RAF Northolt, where she will be taken to Westminster Palace, where she will lie in state until the day of her funeral. There will be other services that the King and the royal family will attend in Northern Ireland and in Wales before the funeral itself next Monday. Needless to say, the clergy have done a lot of reading in the last few days, because none of us have ever been in this situation of what do you do when a monarch dies. And unsurprisingly for the Church of England, there are lots of rules and regulations. When two Sundays are included in the time of official mourning, the second Sunday is the main focus for remembering the life of the Queen, because that is the one that is nearest to the funeral. Therefore, next Sunday will be the Sunday where we will look at the Queen's life, most specifically through her faith, as she would expect us to. This service will include some hymns that were favourites of hers, and all that point to the God that she loved with all her heart. Instead of a sermon today, there will be a very short homily and then a period of about 10 minutes of quiet, where there will be some very gentle music. We're using some music from Rutter's Requiem. The Queen loved John Rutter's music. And it will be an opportunity for you to sit and think and pray, maybe to remember those who are very much on your hearts today. The death of the Queen will undoubtedly have evoked your own losses. It will also be an opportunity for those of you who wish to light a candle for Her Majesty and for anyone else that you wish to today. She had no doubt about who she was and whose she was. She belonged to God, and she is now with her God. The clergy wear purple and black for this period of time as a mark of respect for Her Majesty. And we'll be thinking a little bit more about some of the tributes that have been paid to her later in the service. But from what I know of what I have read of her, what she would want us all to do is to focus on the living God, because that's what she did. So that's what we are going to do. We're going to come to our time of confession, a time when we bring ourselves exactly as we are into the presence of Almighty God, who is already here and who is just waiting for us to talk with Him. So however you are this morning, whatever you feel, whatever has happened in this last week since you last confessed, all of it, you can bring to God, who will hold you and hold it and take away the burden if you allow Him to. So my brothers and sisters, not out of dread or fear, but believing that God is faithful to forgive, let us rid ourselves of what we no longer need to carry. In a dark and disfigured world, we have not held out the light of the Father's gift of life to those who need it most. Lord, have mercy. In a hungry and despairing world, we have failed to share the bread of Christ with those who hunger. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
In a cold and loveless world, we have kept the love and comfort of the Holy Spirit to ourselves. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In the power of the Spirit, may God forgive you and restore you, and so fill you with love for the earth that you yearn to care for all of creation.
Amen.
This is the collect written specifically for today. Merciful Father and Lord of all life, we praise you that we are made in your image and reflect your truth and light. We thank you for the life of our late Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, for the love she received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time we may share with your servant Elizabeth that clearer vision promised to us in the same Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Could we have our first reading, please?
A reading from the Book of Lamentations. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord, for the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. So we do not lose heart, even though our outer nature is wasting away. Our inner nature is being renewed day by day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure. Because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporal, but what cannot be seen is eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For this tent we groan, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, if indeed, when we have taken it off, we will not be found naked. For while we were still in this tent, we groan under our burden, because we wish not to be unclothed, but to be further clothed, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. This is the word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
As we prepare to hear our gospel reading, we stand to sing the Queen's favourite hymn, The Lord's My Shepherd.
Thank you. says the Lord, that I should lose none of all that he has given me, but raise them up on the last day.
Hallelujah.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. But I said to you that you have seen me, and yet do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Father, we pray that you would take these words and our thoughts and our prayers, and that you would mould them into something beautiful for you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please sit down. The news on Thursday is one of those moments you will never forget. You will know and remember exactly where you were and what you were doing the moment that you heard that the Queen had died. Who could have imagined on Tuesday, when she did her last constitutional engagement in receiving the new Prime Minister, that 48 hours later, she would be gone. At 96, we should not be surprised. But she had so many qualities, it seemed like she would go on forever. And the mark of the woman has been reflected so many times in the last few days, from the thousands of comments which have been made, many of them by world leaders, the great and the good, those for whom she was not their queen, but for whom she was the queen. She's been called in the last 3 days, grandmother to the world, guiding light, a moral compass. She showed us how to act, the rock on which modern Britain is built. Thoughtful, wise, curious, helpful, funny. A stateswoman of unmatched standing. The Queen of Hearts who marked a century forever, the greatest diplomat in the world, the still point at the heart of our nation, the most respected of all monarchs. She was head of state when Churchill was Prime Minister, and he was born in 1876. She was head of state when Liz Truss became Prime Minister, and she was born in 1975. She was our Queen, and to a small group of people, she was Mama and Grandmother. Her Majesty transcended politics, arguments, creeds, colours, faiths, nationalities, and held a unique position of respect and trust
across the world, from world leaders to the ordinary man, woman, and child in the street. She enjoyed the trappings and privileges of royalty, and she willingly and wholeheartedly paid the price for them in her endless, untiring work for those she served in this nation, the Commonwealth, and the territories. She began her reign as queen of an empire and ended it as arguably the most beloved monarch in our history, who welcomed the changes that her reign saw. The second great Elizabethan age is over, and our king is all too aware of the huge role that he is now taking responsibility for, and for which he has trained his whole life. The Queen was driven by an abiding sense of duty, but she was sustained by her tremendous faith. Our readings today speak of God's faithfulness, which is new every morning, God's promises of goodness and salvation for those who seek him. Our readings offer hope, hope that whatever the pain of our current difficulties, glory awaits. Heaven is there for those who trust in God. As Paul said, "For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure, because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal." The Queen was not shy to tell us that Jesus was her focus. He was the bread that sustained her. She belonged to him. Every day began with prayer and Bible study. Every evening ended with prayer, thankfulness, and trust in God's unfailing love. She had no fear of death. She knew where she was going, straight into the arms of her Heavenly Father. We trust that she was received with the words, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Come, take your rest. You've earned it." The servant queen is now just Elizabeth in the presence of her great king. She wears the crown reserved for every single one of us as princes and princesses in the kingdom of God, heirs of the kingdom of King Jesus. She is home, and we thank God for her life of promises fulfilled. And so we will now have a time with some very gentle music in the background for you to think, to pray, to light a candle, just to have some space in the chaos of life, and to thank God for the hope that we have in him because of Jesus. Thank you, John. Thank you. haven't yet lit a candle and wish to do so, feel free to come at any point in the service, maybe when you come for communion. We see tears and celebration for this life so dignified, bearing thanks and hearts of sadness to the God of death and life, as he takes her to his promise of an audience with the King. We remember all she gave us, wreaths of gratitude we bring. In these days of change and trial, be the rock on which we stand. When we fear in this new season, Lord, hold us firmly in your hands. May we rise to her example, to be humble, kind and fair, swift to pray and slow to anger, choosing faith and not despair. Lord, forgive when pride and envy leave our nation bruised and stained. Turn us back towards our calling to make your name great again. May we rise above divisions. Lord, our brokenness we bring, that a more united kingdom would give glory to the King. When our days are at their dimming and our work on earth is done, may we hear, as does our Sovereign, faithful servant, welcome home. May we rise with Christ to witness a new heaven and earth displayed, ours a robe that will not tarnish, hers a crown that will not fade. Could we please have our intercessions?
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we bless your holy name for all that you have given us in and through the life of your servant, Queen Elizabeth. We mourn her passing. We give you thanks for her love of family and her gift of friendship, for her devotion to this nation and the nations of the Commonwealth, for her grace, dignity and courtesy, and for her generosity and love of life. We praise you for the courage that she showed in testing times, the depth of her Christian faith, and the witness she bore to it in word and deed. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our Sovereign Lord, the King, and all the royal family, that you might assure them of your continuing love and lift them from the depths of grief into the peace and light of your presence. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
We ask you to be with all who live in darkness, holding on to those affected by the floods in Pakistan. May your love and light protect all the depressed and despairing. May your strength and hope be known to the discouraged. We ask your blessing upon all who are ill at home or in hospital, including Reverend Simon, Elijah G, Roy G, Sophie P, Canon Christine Bullimore, Paul H, Ken, Sophie H, Hernandez, Sharon H, Marion W, Brian F, Nancy N, Maria, Denise G, Daniel, Daryl, Linda, Penny, Danny, Vivian, Amrin, Alison and Jill. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for all who are entering the shadow of death and for their loved ones in their time of anxiety. We pray for all who have passed through death and entered life eternal, including Queen Elizabeth II, Anne M, Marjorie B, and Lillian G. Lord, in your mercy, merciful Father,
morning, everyone.
Morning.
I don't think I've ever been so long without opening my mouth. I just want to, probably some of you will have noticed that my stone bears a royal emblem. And I have the privilege of wearing this stone because I've actually served as a minister on behalf of the Queen. Not the most glamorous of places, HM Prison Army, but I'm firmly convinced that the Queen's faith made that place as important as anywhere else where people ministered on her behalf. It's equally important to all the glamorous places where people served her. And I'm proud to wear this. So, would you all please stand? We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes the peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. So let's remain standing and sing our offertory hymn, Breathe On Me, Breath of God. is the greatness, the power, and the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we give you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread and wine to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. They will become for us our spiritual food and drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Almighty God, good Father to us all, your face is turned towards your world. In love you gave us Jesus, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home to the city where angels sing your praise. The darkness, Jesus came as your light, with signs of faith and words of hope. He touched the unclean with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story.
This is our story. Hosanna.
The crowds came out to see your Son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, he gave thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body given for you." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it and said, "This is my blood shed for you all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is our song.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again, and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Send your Holy Spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with open eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Lord, we are one body because we all share in one
table, not of the church, but of the Lord. It is made ready for those who love him and those who want to love him more. So come, you who have much faith, and you who have little. You who have been here often, and you who have not been for a long time. You who have tried to follow, and you who have failed, come. Not because I invite you. It is the Lord, it is his will that those who want him should meet him here. Abraham, whose church on earth is a sign of your heavenly peace, an image of the new and eternal Jerusalem. Grant to us in the days of our pilgrimage that faith with the living bread of heaven, and united in the body of your Son, we may be the temple of your presence, the peace, the place of your glory on earth, and the sign of your peace in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
We would like to have the church open a little bit more than usual in these next days to give people in our community an opportunity to come into church, to have some time to think and to reflect, to sign the book of the condolence should they wish to. Church will be open on Wednesday morning as usual for our midweek communion, which Robert is leading this week. Yes, Robert's leading this week. And then it's the Heritage Weekend next weekend. As some of you may be aware, the events planned have been postponed as a mark of respect to the Queen. But the church will still be open for people to look at the church as they would for the Heritage Weekend anyway, but also to have a space to be here. And we'd like to have the church open for a long period of time. In order to do that, we need volunteers to staff the opening. So can you please talk to Brian, if you are available, and Phil, to increase the amount of time that the church is open next Saturday and Sunday. That would be very, very grateful. PCC was due to be on the 19th, which is the day of the Queen's funeral. And so that has now been moved to the 26th of September. Angel's Cafe will be open on Wednesday as usual. I am indebted this week to Elaine, who put this service together at the very last minute, because I was away all week at the clergy conference, and she's been an absolute rock getting everything sorted out for today. To John, Judith and Brian, who helped to create the area of condolence and the very beautiful flowers that we have. To the bell ringers who came in and rang for an hour at midday on Friday. The muted bells for Her Majesty. I'm very grateful for the way people have pulled together. And for Emma, who has been on social media and making sure that everything is as up to date as it possibly can be. Please keep an eye out for any changes that there may be happening in this coming week as things develop. And my last notice for today is that this afternoon at 3 o'clock, Sabby and her family are having a memorial service for Sally's mum and her sister. Her mum died in August and her sister died a year ago. And because of where they died, Sally wasn't able to go to the funerals because they were in Trinidad. And so this afternoon we are going to have a memorial service. Her niece is here from Australia. And other members of the family who reside in the UK will be here. And we too are her family. And as her family, she would like to extend a warm welcome to anybody who would like to come and join in with this service of thanksgiving for her family. There will be refreshments afterwards, and it is going to be live streamed literally around the globe. So please, come and support Sally and her family, if you are able, this afternoon at 3 o'clock.
we stand for our final hymn, Amazing Grace. God grant to the living grace to the departed, rest to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all humankind, peace and comfort, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those you love and care for this day and always.
Amen.
So go in peace to love and